You want to breed fish and raise fry like the pros. You're going to need live food. Good news, it's easier than you think. And today I'm going to show you how to make your own microworm culture. Microworms or banana worms are one of my favorite live foods for newly hatched fish because of how easy it is to maintain the culture and how quickly they reproduce. If you're looking for a live food culture that'll be perfect for getting your adult fish to breed, check out that video right there. There'll be an update coming soon for that, as I have been a few different setups now doing well, and I've learned some pretty cool things. As far as the microworms though, first things first, you're going to need a starter culture. They're fairly cheap, usually around $5. If you could find one from a local fish hobbyist, that's ideal. You should be able to find them online. I was lucky enough to pick one up at my local fish club.
Here is the microworm culture I am starting with. I picked it up at the Tampa Bay Aquarium Society.
This is your friendly reminder to check out your local fish club. Not only can you score great deals on stuff like this and fish and plants, you meet awesome people. Big shout out to Steph and George. You're gonna need some mashed potatoes, just the regular original kind, nothing funky or flavorful. You're gonna need a cheap plastic container. I prefer one that has some higher walls. You'll find out why in a little bit. You're gonna need something to kind of make a screen. I just like using stuffing because it's around the fish room. A scissor, something to puncture a hole, and some water. You may have heard you can use oats or taters. I prefer taters. There's a few reasons for that. This culture can be a stinky culture. In my opinion, it hasn't been one. And I've heard online that the oat culture can smell more than this one. I haven't had any issues with the potato culture smelling. Second reason is harvesting. One of the big things that I always look for when I'm gonna bring on a new food is how easy is it to harvest? Some of the live foods out there, fairly difficult. Microworms, as you'll see, pretty easy. Also, using mashed potatoes makes it even easier. Third reason why, my starter culture came in potatoes. Let's get started. Let's prep our container first, and we're gonna need some ventilation. So I'm gonna go here and take a hole and poke it through. These things, like I said, are good for smaller fish. They sink, they don't really float. They'll last in your aquarium water for a little bit of time, not indefinitely, but they're not gonna die right away in the aquarium water. You're gonna wanna make just a hole. This is no method to the madness here, but just something with airflow, and then you don't need that much, and just kinda plug the hole. That way you're letting air get through, but not any kind of mites or anything to contaminate the culture. I haven't had any issues with contaminants here. I know some cultures are prone to contamination, but in my experience, these microworm cultures, you know, have been fine and they've been pure. We're gonna get started just by sprinkling some of the dry mashed potatoes. Remember, it's important just to kind of get like the one with no additives or weird stuff. I just kind of cover the bottom, and we're gonna add some just regular tap water. I don't get too crazy with it, not too much. We're looking for a consistency that's gonna be fairly, it's like not too thick, not too thin, kind of a Goldilocks situation, I guess. But essentially not too runny, but not like thick potatoes. As far as how much, like I said, this is very much an eyeball thing. You're gonna wanna coat the bottom at least in terms of potatoes. So you wanna keep adding your flake and water. Now, some people use yeast. I haven't felt the need to use yeast. I've been having these cultures going for, a few months now. And I've split them. I've already split this culture up because they're very, very prolific. Looks like I got enough kind of potatoes here. I'm gonna keep stirring. Gonna add a little more water. As you can see, it's kind of like, still kind of dry. So we're gonna add a little more water. I think I have enough flakes, so I'm gonna be a little more precise with the water now as we're getting down to it. You're gonna want them like, a little bit runnier than maybe you'd want them yourself, but not runny enough that they'd, slip out of the container, doing one of these. So that looks about right to me. Just kind of, flatten it out as best you can. And what we're gonna do now is take some of our starter culture, and what I'm gonna do is kind of regenerate this culture as well. As you can see, the top is kind of crystallized over. Part of the maintenance for this, and one of the benefits I like about this, is it's pretty low maintenance. So the maintenance that I've been doing on it is kind of just stirring it up every few days, making sure you collect from the culture. I'm gonna show you how to do that in a second. This is a culture that can reproduce fairly quickly. So, I mean, you can run into boom and bust. I'm feeding out of these, you know, every day, every other day. Some people you can even feed, I think, twice a day, depending on, you know, what you're feeding, obviously. But what I'm going to do is not only take some potatoes out of this culture and put it into here, I'm going to take some fresh potatoes out of our culture we just started and put it back into here to kind of replenish this one to make sure it doesn't crash. So I'm kind of almost like a 50-50. I'm going to take us a nice kind of a generous scoop of our culture that's already been established and lay it right on top there. And then what I'm going to do is take a scoop from the other side where we haven't got any of the new culture and kind of put it back into this culture. And this will allow me to kind of a two for one. It's spreading my new culture, and it's also kind of helping the previous one last a little longer. I'm gonna kind of give it a stir and stir it in, because like I said, you wanna stir these cultures every few days anyway. So now this culture's kind of got a big boost now of some fresh taters. And we can set this one aside. And then over here, like I said, we can kind of just, you know, move this out again. You don't have to stir this in. I feel like if you do, it kind of, it may seed it quicker. I've started these before in the last few weeks just to kind of give it a try before I made this video. And I did a few where I mixed it in, a few where I didn't touch anything, a few where I kind of did like this where I mixed it in a little bit. And they all seeded fine and they're all doing well. And I'm feeding out of all of them now. It doesn't take long for these to get going. I keep them in my house at room temperature. You could keep them, you know, in warmer temperature and colder temperature, I'm sure, to a little bit. But room temperature seems to do well. And like I said, this is gonna be your culture. You may wanna get some of the potatoes off the side. I'll explain to you why in a second, because that's kind of how you harvest. And that's also why you want this, you know, these tall sides is nice. Something with like, you know, long, tall sides is ideal, because as you'll see, the worms are gonna crawl up the side, and that's how you can collect them. These are two of the cultures that I was talking about that I had made previously, both off of this original culture. And I kind of did the same thing where I recharged it when I made these a few weeks ago. And we're gonna feed off of these today. And as you can see, there's kind of like a haze building up on the side. That is all worms. I'm gonna try to get a close up for you guys here, but in order to collect for harvesting, some people use a Q-tip or, you know, different apparatus. I'm sure you can figure out a lot of different things. What I do is stick my finger in there. So I just kind of stick my finger. You don't want to get too deep to get in all the mashed potatoes, but literally all up on the side there is just thousands, if not, you know, hundreds of thousands of worms in this whole culture. Then you just dip it into the tank to feed. And the good thing about using the mashed potatoes is they're going to eat it usually. The fish will eat it, shrimp will eat it, snails will eat it, or, you know, it will kind of, it will foul the water if it doesn't get eaten. It is, you know, just like feeding extra fish food, but it's not a lot, you know. So if for some reason you do get some potato into your tank when feeding, I haven't had any issues. Now, you don't want to just take a scoop of the potatoes and dump it in. But like I said, if you get some extra potatoes, no harm, no foul. Best of luck to you with your live culture. For more live foods, click there. For more wild fish tank antics, right over there. As always, if you haven't subscribed, click right there. Stay positive and stay passionate.